In today's lecture, you will learn about limiting reactant and excess reactant and some of the self problems related to this topic, that is limiting reactant. Now, here the definition of limiting reactant is given. The reactant that produces the least number of moles of the product, that is termed as limiting reactant, or the reactant which is consumed completely in a chemical reaction and due to which the reaction stops. The non-stoichiometric amounts of reactants are used in this chemical reaction, that is called a limiting reactant, right? Now, what about the non-stoichiometric amount? That one of the substance or one of the reactant will be in excessive amount and the other one will be in the limited amount. So what will happen? Which one will act as the limiting one and which one will be in the excess? Now, here the excess reactant is the reactant which is left unreacted or unused after completion of reaction is termed as excessive reactant. Once again, non-stoichiometric means no proper or no complete prefixes, that is 2, 3, 4, 5 or whatever the number of moles, they are not applied, right? Then we say this one reaction is going to give you the amounts which are non-stoichiometric, means not a balanced chemical equation that will be. Okay, now come to the next. To define limiting reactant, one of our everyday example is mentioned here. Now here you can see a jar of peanut butter and some slices of bread are there. The slices are actually 8 in number and we are having one jar of peanut butter. So how many sandwiches will come out of it or you can make from this? Definitely 2 slices for each sandwich. So you will apply butter. Peanut butter over it and we will get total of the 4 peanut butter sandwiches, while the leftover will be the amount of the peanut butter. One of them is the limiting reactant while the other one is the excess reactant. I hope you are going to get the point that bread slices, they are acting as the limiting reactant, that all are consumed right in this process of making sandwiches, while the peanut butter is still remain there as it is excessive in amount, so it is the excess reactant. Comes to the chemical reactions, that how to identify the limiting reactant in chemical reactions. So look at this example, that 10 moles of hydrogen and 7 moles of oxygen, they react to produce water. Which one of the reactant is the limiting reactant? We can calculate it as follows. The reaction is given as 2H2 plus O2 produces 2H2O. Now, we are given with the 10 moles of hydrogen and 7 moles of oxygen. We have to find out which of them is the limiting reactant. Now, take a look at this. Again, you are familiar that how to understand this equation. The equation tells you that 2 moles of hydrogen, 2 moles of hydrogen reacts with 1 mole of oxygen to produce 2 moles of water. You have been given 10 moles. Just make a mole ratio between hydrogen and water first and then oxygen and water, right? You can see the mole ratio is equal on both sides, that when you have used hydrogen and water for the mole ratio, both of them that carry same number of moles in them, that is 2:2, the ratio is there. What will be the number of moles of water produced? Definitely 10 moles of hydrogen will produce 10 moles of water, right? But when we say oxygen and water mole ratio is there, we have 1 mole which is producing 2 moles of water according to this balanced chemical equation, right? Now what will happen when we have 7 moles of oxygen, what will be there? 2 upon 1 multiplied by 7. Double is the number of moles of water. So you are going to get 14 moles of water in it. What do you think? Which one of these two is the limiting reactant? Find it out. Hydrogen is producing 10 moles of water, while oxygen is producing 14 moles of water. The less number of moles of water are produced by 10 moles of water. So water will act as our limiting reactant, while the other one is producing greater number of moles of water. So this reactant is in excess. That 10 moles of water will require less number of moles of oxygen as compared to 7. Right? This one is what we say to identify limiting reactant in the equations. Once again, limiting reactant is found by means of relating the mole ratios of the two reactants to the product, so that the substance which will produce the least number of moles of product, that will be considered as the limiting reactant in the equation. Now here it is mentioned, sample problem 1.5, according to which 200 grams of potassium dichromate reacts with 200 grams of concentrated sulfuric acid. There are two objectives. Number one, calculate mass of atomic oxygen produced and mass of the reactant left unreacted. Now here the amounts of the two reactants are mentioned. To which quantity of the reactant, among the two reactants, we have to find out the mass of the atomic oxygen in relation to. So this is a numerical of the limiting reactant here. Now what to do? The first one step is the conversion of these masses, that is the mass of potassium dichromate and mass of concentrated sulfuric acid, into their respective moles. So for this, potassium dichromate mass given is 200 grams, while the formula mass given is 294 grams, in which potassium is with 39, chromium 56, and oxygen with the 16. So multiply these masses with their atomic atoms present in the formula and then add them up. You will get your answer as 294 grams. Then you have to calculate the moles by applying the formula, that 200 divided by 294, the moles which are produced, that is 0.68. Now in the similar way, find out the moles of the sulfuric acid. The quantity of sulfuric acid given is 200. Here the moles of sulfuric acid are found by means of first calculating its mole formula mass, that comes out as 98 grams by adding hydrogen at atomic mass, that is 1, with sulfur 32 and oxygen with 16, multiplying with their number of atoms present in this formula unit. Then the formula applied is, that is given mass over molar mass, that is 200 grams is divided by 98, so moles comes out as 2.04 moles. Now the balanced chemical equation is given as potassium dichromate reacts with sulfuric acid to give potassium sulfate, chromium sulfate, water and more atomic oxygen. In molar quantities, we will say 1 mole of potassium dichromate reacts with 4 moles of sulfuric acid to produce 1 mole of potassium sulfate, 1 mole of chromium sulfate, 4 moles of water and 3 moles of atomic oxygen. Now we have to relate the mole ratios of potassium dichromate with oxygen and sulfuric acid with oxygen, as the mass of oxygen is being asked to be calculated. Right? So first of all, relate potassium dichromate with oxygen. Remember the moles which we found by 200 grams of this substance, that is 0.68. Now according to the balanced chemical equation, 1 mole of potassium dichromate is producing 3 moles of oxygen. How much oxygen is generated by 0.68 moles of potassium dichromate? So it will be 3 upon 1 multiplied by 0.68 moles of oxygen. That is, this one will be the factor which is called conversion factor. The moles of oxygen produced are 2.04 moles, right? Similarly, when 4 moles of sulfuric acid are applied, 4 moles of sulfuric acid, according to the equation, are producing 3 moles of oxygen, while 2.04 moles from the calculated one above quantity, the conversion factor found is 3/4 multiplied by 2.04. The moles appeared, they are 1.53 moles. Now here, find which one is the limiting reactant. Of course, sulfuric acid will act as the limiting reactant because it is producing 1.53 moles of oxygen, while potassium dichromate was producing 2.04. Means sulfuric acid is the limiting reactant while potassium dichromate is the reactant in excess. Now, with respect to these number of moles produced by the limiting reactant, we will find the mass of oxygen. Now here, this slide gives you what the mass of oxygen produced from 1.53 moles of it, which are produced by means of sulfuric acid. Now here we have the formula N multiplied by molar mass. 1.53 moles of oxygen multiplied by 16, that is its atomic mass, is equal to 24.48 grams of oxygen. This is the amount of oxygen which will be produced in this reaction. Now this is the second part of the numerical which is solved here. The limiting reactant is sulfuric acid, so we have to find out that how many moles of potassium dichromate reacted with the 2.04 moles of sulfuric acid, right? So for this, again we have to go to the balanced chemical equation. According to the equation, 4 moles of sulfuric acid reacts with 1 mole of potassium dichromate. Now here we have the amount of the sulfuric acid in moles, that is 2.04. How it will react with potassium dichromate, which will come out as 1/4 multiplied by 2.04. This is 0.51 moles of potassium dichromate, which reacted with the 2.04 moles of sulfuric acid. Now, what is the leftover or what is in excess? Subtract this number of moles, that is 0.51, from the moles we observed by using 200 grams of it. So it is 0.68 minus 0.51, that is the moles comes out as 0.17 moles. Now convert it into the mass, for which we have to multiply this number of moles with the molar mass of potassium dichromate. So the amount produced is 49.98 grams. This is the amount out of 200 grams which is left unreacted. So this is the reactant which is in excess, that is potassium dichromate. Now one by one we have followed there the steps, that is number one, a balanced chemical equation you have to write. Number two, convert the given masses into moles, then find out in the third one step, find out the mole ratios and the amount of the product produced. The substance which is giving the least amount of product, that will be considered as the limiting reactant. Regarding this, we have to find out the mass of the substance being asked, and then when you have to find out the excess amount of the reactant, then follow the last one step, that find out the number of moles which reacted with the limiting reactant, and then you can find out the excessive amount of the excess reactant, right? Now, before we go to this self-check exercise 1.4, you have to learn yourself the two sample problems given in your book before this self-check, and tell me then whether you are going to understand them or not. They are regarding to the limiting reactant. Quite easy. they are repeated, so that's why I haven't given them on the slides, but you have to do them yourself. Now come to the self-check exercise 1.4. The numerical given is zinc and sulfur react to form zinc sulfide. The formula is ZnS according to the following equation. Here the equation is given. Zn plus S reacts to produce zinc sulfide, ZnS. Now, if 6 grams of zinc and 4 grams of sulfur are available for reaction, then determine number 1 the limiting reactant and number 2 the mass of zinc sulfide produced. Because you have to find out 3 steps in it, right? First of all, as the equation is given itself, so you don't have to write it. First of all, you have to convert these grams into the moles, right? So first for zinc, it is done. Zinc having the atomic mass 64.41, or you can take it as a round figure, that is of 65, right? The given mass is 6 grams, so the mass in grams will be how much? You will say 6 upon 65.41 will give you 0.0917 moles, right? This is the number of moles of zinc which are produced from 6 gram of the substance. Now the second was find out the number of moles of sulfur. The sulfur given was 4 grams, while the molar mass of sulfur is 32. The moles produced are 0.125. Right? Now, make up the mole ratios. First, before zinc, between zinc and zinc sulfide. Make up the mole ratio between zinc and zinc sulfide according to the equation given above. 1:1 ratio is there for these two. So if there are 0.0917 moles of zinc, same number of moles of zinc sulfide will be produced, that 0.0917 moles, is it? Similarly, again the ratio between sulfur and zinc sulfide is also same, that is 1:1. So the number of moles which are used in the reaction for sulfur will give you the same amount of product, that is 0.125 moles of zinc sulfide. Now compare the two moles which are produced by means of zinc and sulfur. The lower number of moles of zinc sulfide are produced by means of zinc. So zinc will be considered as the limiting reactant in this reaction. Right? Now, you have to find out the mass of the zinc sulfide produced in this reaction. So what you have to do? Calculate first the mass of the zinc sulfide. Here, add the two molar masses of zinc and sulfur. 65.5 plus 32 will give you the total 97.41 grams. Multiply this mass with the number of moles produced by means of zinc. Remember it. You have to make use of the moles which are produced by the limiting reactant. The amount produced is 8.94 grams of zinc sulfide. So we say in this reaction, zinc is the limiting reactant while the mass of zinc sulfide produced is 8.96. Now this is the second numerical given, that aluminium reacts with bromine form aluminium bromide, as the reaction is given. If you have been given 15.8 grams of aluminium and 55.6 grams of bromine, then find out the limiting reactant. A part is this one and the B part is mass of aluminium bromide produced. According to the equation, we can find the molar ratios, that is 2 moles of aluminium reacts with 3 moles of bromine and produces 2 moles of aluminium bromide. The first step is you have to convert the masses into their moles. So what the formula is used? W by M, that is given mass over the molar mass. Given mass is 15.8 for aluminium and its molar mass is 27, so it comes out 0.585 moles of aluminium, right? For bromine, the molar mass of bromine is 159.8 or approximately 160, as the mass of its one atom is 79.9. In Br2, there are two atoms, so multiplied with 2, the mass of it comes out, that is 55.6 upon 159.8 will give you the moles, 0.348 moles. Now the two moles are being calculated. Aluminium with AlBr3 first, and then of Br2 with AlBr3 once again. For the first one, 2 moles of aluminium produces 2 moles of AlBr3. Again, the same is the mole ratio on both sides. Same amount of aluminium produces same amount of AlBr3. So, if we have 0.585 moles of it, then the same amount or same moles will be produced of AlBr3, that is 0.585 moles. While in case of bromine, 3:2 is the ratio which is given. It is the conversion factor. Then calculate by means of multiplying with the number of moles of bromine. It is 0.348 will give you 0.232 moles of AlBr3. Now compare the moles of AlBr3 produced from from Br2, that is 0.232 moles, and then the moles of AlBr3 produced from aluminium, that is 0.585 moles. Which one is the less quantity? Definitely, it is the quantity which is produced by using bromine, 0.232. So we will say bromine is our limiting reactant. Now the last step is left, that is you have to find out the mass of the substance. So calculate first the molar mass of AlBr3, which will come out as 266.7 grams, right? Multiply it with the number of moles produced by the limiting reactant, so the mass comes out as 61.9 grams. This is how to do or how to solve numericals of limiting reactant. Now it is another simple problem which is given. According to this, 1.87 moles of ammonium chloride are reacting with that of the 1.35 moles of calcium hydroxide. Now here the moles are given itself, not the masses are given, right? How many grams of calcium hydroxide are left unreacted in this reaction? Again, the question is so simple. You don't have to find out the limiting reactant, but it is mentioned here that ammonium chloride is the limiting reactant. The substance in excess is calcium hydroxide, as you have to calculate its quantity, right? Now you just have to do what? That you have to find that how much quantity, how many moles of calcium hydroxide reacted with 1.87 moles of ammonium chloride, right? You just have to do this one. Now the equation is given, calcium hydroxide reacts with the 2 moles of ammonium chloride to produce calcium chloride, 1 mole and 2 moles of ammonium hydroxide. Now according to this equation, there is the mole ratio of 1:2, right? We know that the limiting reactant is ammonium chloride, so we will say there is the mole ratio of 2:1, that 2 moles of ammonium chloride reacting with the 1 mole of calcium hydroxide. As we have to calculate the moles of calcium hydroxide which reacted with 1.87 moles of ammonium chloride, right? Here it is given, 2 moles of ammonium chloride reacts with 1 moles of calcium hydroxide. So how many moles of calcium hydroxide will react with 1.87 moles? The term is given, that is 1 upon 2 multiplied by 1.87, the answer is 0.935. Now out of 135 moles of calcium hydroxide, the utilized ones are only 0.935. So subtract it from 1.35, you will get there 0.415 moles, which left unreacted. Now convert it into mass. what you have to do, you will convert it into mass by multiplying it with the molar mass of calcium hydroxide, which is calculated as 74, calcium with 40, oxygen with 16, and hydrogen with 1. Right? The next one. This is the slide which is giving you the differentiation between limiting and excess reactant. I hope you will easily understand them now. They are not so difficult. Limiting reactant is one that is in a particular reaction that limits the formation of the product, which limits the formation of the product, while the excess reactant is the reactant that is present in excess in the reaction mixture. Then number two, completely consumed during the reaction, that is the limiting reactant, while not completely consumed in the reaction, that is the excess reactant. Not the present at the end of the reaction, the limiting reactant, it is whole used, while the limiting reactant is in excess, so it will be left, some amount of it will be left. Now the last point is limits the amount of the product, definitely, as it is consumed first, so the amount of the product depends upon it. As it finished, so the product stops to be formed, right? While the limiting reactant is not going to affect the product form in the chemical reaction, as it is left, it is in excess, right? So these all are the differences. You have to learn them well, right? Now at the end, there is given the homework. Do it and submit it so that I can check it.